station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Gary Jordan. We're continuing our summer road trip, showing off some of the sites at the NASA Johnson Space Center. Today, we're in the Columbia Center. This facility is used for enhancing the health and well-being of astronauts preparing for or returning from spaceflight. On board station this week, the crew members cranked their workout routine to 11 in the name of science. Jack Fisher took part in the Sprint experiment. This study looks at the benefits of using high-intensity aerobic exercise and low-volume resistance exercise to minimize muscle and bone loss during long stays in space. On Wednesday, Fisher put his workout routine to the test on the stationary bicycle going full speed, then hit the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device, or ARED, for his second workout of the day. ARED is the machine that simulates weightlifting on the station. Fisher will be participating in this study throughout his stay on board. Peggy Whitson was working at a microscopic scale this week, manipulating cell cultures in three dimensions. Whitson tested some samples this week for the magnetic 3D cell culture experiment. In the weightless environment of space, cell cultures spontaneously grow in three dimensions, as opposed to the typical two dimensions on Earth. But they're hard to control. This experiment uses magnetized cells and tools to make it easier to handle these microscopic samples and study them routinely. Whitson tested out techniques, literally levitating them and controlling them with magnets. This week's question comes from Jamie, who wants to know how living on the International Space Station can affect one's sleep, and if they sleep based on any time zones. Well, as you might imagine, we have a few experiments for that. Astronauts and cosmonauts aboard the International Space Station operate on Greenwich Mean Time, or GMT. There are mission control centers all over the world, so international partners compromised on this time zone, a nice spot in the middle. But besides the jet lag from switching time zones upon arriving at the station, there are many other factors that could affect sleep. Like the fact that zooming around the Earth every 90 minutes means 16 sunrises and sunsets per day. Studies like circadian rhythms, which measures an astronaut's biological clock over time, as well as the lighting effect study, which looks at how LED lights with adjustable brightness and color can improve sleep and cognitive performance, all help to make sure astronauts are getting the good night's rest that they deserve. Keep sending your questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space. Space.